CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello students, I hope you are happy and enjoying your stay at home with your parents and siblings. You may not be missing the school, but we teachers, you know, we are missing you all. We are missing your little mischiefs. We are missing the noises that you create in the classrooms. So, we teachers decided to teach you through radio. So, here I am, your maths teacher, Bharati. And today, we will discuss your first chapter from NCERT Mathematics Textbook for Class 5. The name of the chapter is Fish Tales. You know, quite interesting title that we have for this chapter, Fish Tales. If you are living near the sea or river, or you have visited a pond or maybe a fish aquarium, big fish aquarium or pet shop in your locality, then you might have seen fishes of different shapes, different sizes and different colors. Okay. And all those children who may not have seen fishes of different shapes and sizes, don't worry. You will get enough opportunity in your life to visit the sea, the river or pond or maybe an aquarium in a zoo, where you can see fishes of various shapes and sizes and colors. Now, you might be aware from my talk that fishes are an animal that lives in the water, and fishes can't survive without water, and fishes have different shapes, different sizes, and they also have different colors, beautiful, vibrant colors. From this description of fishes, you might be thinking that all fishes are very sweet in nature, just like you children. Yes, they are, but there are few fishes who may not be as sweet and simple as you children are. There are many fishes which are fighter fishes. They fight with each other. And you know, this is their nature. That is why we call them fighter fishes. I have a friend who has a small aquarium in her house. And in her aquarium, she has kept goldfishes. Goldfishes have orange color. And when they swim, they look so beautiful in her aquarium. If you get a chance to visit a pet shop near your house, please peep into the pet shop and see the beautiful fishes there, if the pet shop owner has some aquariums. Fine. So now let's come back to this chapter. The title of the chapter is Fish Tales. So today we are going to learn a lot about fishes. Now you must be thinking, what fishes have to do with mathematics? Yes, you are right in a way. What fishes has to do with mathematics? If you are studying about fishes, this chapter should be part of your environmental studies or your science textbooks. But you will be surprised by the end of this session that fishes can also be very useful in learning about mathematics. So the first thing that I'm going to do is, I'm going to recite few lines and I'm going to recite them twice. So let's see who all are ready. Yes. So I hope you all are ready for this particular poem. Okay. Deep under the sea, see the lovely colored fish swimming peacefully. Children, you know, these small poems which just have three lines, they are called haiku. Haiku? What a funny name.
Yes, it is a funny name
because it is not Indian name. It's a Japanese name which means small poems with three lines. So let me recite another haiku. Meanwhile, you can try speaking haiku. What is an haiku? These small three-line poems which are related to nature. And in nature, we have animals, we have plants. So all haikus are about nature. So here is another haiku which you can recite second time with me. And this is also related to water and water animals. So here it goes. The lake, calm, smooth, still. A fish jumps up and return. Ripples shake the lake. You know what it is? The lake, calm, smooth, still. A fish jumps up and return. Ripples shake the lake. It's a beautiful haiku. And while reading it, I could imagine the picture of a lake whose surface was very calm, quiet and smooth. And suddenly a fish jumps up, comes back down to the water, and there was a ripple. What is a ripple? It's a circle. When you throw stone in water, the circles are created. These circles on water are called ripples. I really like this haiku. And I hope you also enjoyed this haiku. Okay. So this was about fish and haiku. Now let's relate fishes with the mathematics. And you know, in mathematics, we study about shapes, we study about numbers, we study about size. So now let me ask you, if I say the word fish, then all those who have seen fish, can you think of any shape that comes to your mind? Think. What shape could be that we can relate to mathematics? Yes. Yes, I know. You all are very smart. So you have seen the fish and you can relate it to square and a triangle. And for all those who are still wondering how square and triangle can make a fish, so let's try making a fish using square and triangle. Now, don't tell me you do not remember what a square and a triangle is. A square is a closed figure with four equal sides. And what's a triangle? A triangle is a closed figure with three sides. And in triangle, the sides may or may not be equal, but it is a closed figure. So let's try making a fish using triangle and a square. So where we start from? Okay, let's make a triangle. So draw a triangle in your notebook. Okay, I am also drawing it with you. So let's draw it together. Let's make a small standing line. Okay, now the above end of this standing line, draw a line, another line, a slanted line. And from the bottom point of this standing line, draw another slanting line that meets the previous slanting line at one point. So this triangle now we have made. Let's draw a square there itself using that line. Okay, now as you know, the square has four lines, so we already have our one line. Now from the top point of this standing line, draw another line towards the left of this line, and this should be your sleeping line from the top.
Now from the bottom of this standing line, draw another sleeping line towards the left. But be careful, the size of all these three lines should be same. Then only you will be able to draw the square. I hope you all have drawn this. Now, the fourth side that you are going to draw will be closing this figure. So now I have on my notebook a triangle and a square. Now, the other standing line which has closed my square, I am going to draw another triangle just like I have drawn in the front of this square. Try doing it. Yes, very good. So now you have a figure which has a square in between and two triangles, one in the front and one in the back, and both are adjoining the square. Okay, now the first triangle, it may look like the mouth of a fish, and the triangle at the back, if you'll make a slight dent at the point of the last triangle, then you can have a shape like fish tails. This is how you can make a rough shape of a figure. Now children, look around you, whether you live near sea, lake, river, pond, or you live in urban areas, you may find many designs around you, maybe in your clothes, maybe in your bed sheets, maybe in the sari of your mother, or maybe on the wall paintings where fishes are drawn. Just be aware and try finding fish designs and drawings in your surroundings. Drawing a fish on any place and repeating the fish patterns makes the thing more beautiful and attractive. And you know, children, if you have beautiful eyes, which I'm sure you all have, then person with a beautiful eye is always compared with the fish. And you know, children, Meenakshi. Meenakshi is a name which is derived from fishes only. In Hindi, fish is called Meen and Meenakshi. Meenakshi means the eyes which are like fish, the beautiful eyes which are like fish. So, next time you are looking into the mirror, focus on your eyes and see how beautiful fish-like eyes you have. And just like fishes come in different size, shapes, each person's eye is different. So, if your eyes are small, so they are like small fish. And so if somebody has big eyes, they are like big fish. So, I hope you all enjoy drawing fish using a triangle and a square. Try making different size of triangle, different size of squares, and adding fins to the fish figure that you have made using square and triangles. And you can repeat it to make different patterns. And don't forget to compare your fish drawings with the fish drawings made by your friends, your maybe brother or sister. And you will find each fish drawing would be different from the other person's drawing. And to add more fun to it, you can use colors also later on to color your fishes, to give them bright colors. Okay, so now what next? Let's do something. So, if you have your textbooks with you, please bring your textbook and open page number 2. And what do we have here on this page number 2? We have a picture of a very big fish. And you know the name of this big fish is whale shark. Why do we call it whale shark? We call it whale shark because whale is huge fish which lives in sea. And why do we call it shark? Because of its teeth and its nature. It fights and it kills other small fishes for food. Because of the size, we call this fish as whale shark. And you know, you'll be surprised that a whale breathes through nose just like you and me. And still it lives in water. So for breathing, it has to come to the surface of water after some time. And regularly it keeps on coming to water to breathe. And you know, whale is a fish which doesn't give eggs. It gives birth to babies. So these two facts makes whale fishes little different from other fishes. What are these two facts? First fact is whale breathes through nose, and second fact is it gives birth to babies instead of giving eggs. And you know, children, whales are so huge, still they are harmless. They do not attack humans. And you know, what is the weight of a whale fish? A whale fish is huge in size. So yes, you are right, its weight must be huge. But how huge? So let's try finding the weight of a whale shark. Okay. So, before finding the weight, can anyone tell me what would be the length of this whale shark? You know, the length of the whale shark is 18 meters long. For all those who are wondering how long is 18 meter, I'll give you a clue. If your mother wears a sari, you know how long a sari is? It's around 5.5 meters to 6 meters. And if you will combine 3 saris, then you arrive at 18 meters. Now imagine how big this fish would be. And you know, children, if your mother doesn't wear sari, don't worry. You can combine 6 to 7 dupattas to arrive at the size of this fish. Okay. If this fish is so huge, then what would be its weight? Its weight is around 16,000 kilograms. I know many of you might be thinking, we are not aware how much is 16,000 kilograms. So let's make matters little simple. So let us assume each one of you weighs around 40 kgs. 40 kgs is also huge for you children, okay? You must be weighing around 10 to 12 kgs, not more than that. So, 4 children together weighs around 40 kgs. But since we are discussing about fishes, so let's assume the weight of each one of you is 40 kgs. And now I have to reach what weight? I have to compare weight of 16,000 kilograms with 40 kilograms. So how many children's weight would be equal to that? How many? Let's try with 12 children. Okay. If the weight of each child is 40 kilograms, what will be the total weight of 12 children? How will we come to know that? Yes, very good. We need to multiply 12 into 40. And 12 into 40 is nothing but 480 kilograms. So still it is way less than the 16,000 kilogram. That is the weight of this particular very big fish. How many 480 kilograms we will need to reach 16,000 kilograms? Think about it. We'll need lot of children. How many? How to find this? You have to divide 16,000 with 40. And the number that you reach by dividing 16,000 by 40 is nothing but 400. So you know, 400 children, each child weighing 40 kgs. That would be the weight of one fish. This is so huge. So now you know, by studying about fishes, we can find out the shapes and we can also know about the weight. So this is nothing but mathematics. And you know, fishes also teach us lot many things about water. So we have just studied about only one fish, that is whale shark, and she is so huge that 400 children, each child weighing 40 kgs is equal to the weight of one fish, and three saris combined together is the length of that particular fish. So see, we can't keep this kind of fish in aquariums. They are in the free water and huge water bodies called sea. And you know, children, fishes also have schools. Now, many of you must be smiling. School for fishes? Yes, the school for fish do exist, but it is not like the schools in which you are studying. A group of fishes who swim together is called school of fish. And in a school of fish, you can have around one, two, not one. If it's a single fish, it is not a school of fish. In a school of fish, we have more than 10 fishes, sometimes less also if the size is big, like whale fish. So, if the fishes are very small in size, they swim together in thousands, meaning 1,000 small fishes swimming together. And sometimes they swim together in hundreds also. So depending on their different likings, different sizes, they create their own schools. So what is fish school or school of fish? It's a group of fishes swimming together. And you know why they swim together? They swim together because swimming together makes them feel safe. They feel safer in groups. And you know, sometimes a very small fish, if the fish senses some danger, this small fish drinks lot of water so that the body swells up like a balloon with air. And many a times, the other animals who came to kill or make some harm to this fish, they are scared away. They become so afraid that they run away from this small fish. And once the danger is out, then this fish comes back to its original size. Isn't it interesting? Yes, I know this is very interesting. So, very interesting facts about fishes that we have learned today. Let me tell you the name of few fishes which is given in your textbook page number 4. You know, there is a fish called sea urchin. It's like a ball with lots of spikes coming out of its body. It's like a ball with lots of needles in the ball. Okay, so it is called sea urchin. Then we have another fish which is called eel. Eel is a fish which looks like a snake. And a snake in dark may look like a rope. So eel is that kind of fish. And all fishes live in water. Some live in fresh water like rivers. And some live in sea water, which is salty water. Then we have another fish which is lobster. A lobster more or less looks like a triangle. And then we have a red snapper. Why we call it red snapper? Because it is red in color and it may be very angry all the time. That is why it is called red snapper. And then what else we have? On page 5, we have a fish which is called parrotfish. A parrotfish? Yes. The name is parrotfish. And you can discuss it with your friends and family members, or you may Google it, or you may find more information about this parrotfish. Then we have a prawn. A prawn is another fish which has more than two legs. It has many legs. And then we have a fish called cuttlefish. It's a fish like a small onion with lots of legs coming from one end. And we have a jellyfish. A jellyfish is like a big plate, or if it's a small one, it can be a small plate. And from the side of the plate, the rim of the plate, small fins are coming out. So this is jellyfish, and it's very sticky, looks like a jelly also, and quite flexible. Then we have silver pomfret. Silver pomfret is a small kind of a fish with forked tail and two huge fins. And we have another fish called octopus. Octopus, the name itself, octo means eight. So a fish with eight legs is called octopus. Octopus also has a head like a bulb, and from the other end, eight legs are coming out. And you know, children, crab is also one kind of a fish. And I'm reading all the names from your textbook. So if you have access to your textbooks, just look at the page 5, and I'm sure you will enjoy looking at the picture of various fishes in your textbook. So today, what we have learned? We have learned that haiku is a Japanese small poem which has 3 lines, and all these 3 line haikus are related to nature. And we also learned about the shapes with which we can draw the fishes, a triangle and a square. Then we also learned about the different shape size of the fishes, and we have learned in detail about whale shark, the size and the weight of a whale shark. Hope you enjoyed this session. So till we meet again, stay home, stay safe, and obey your parents, and don't fight with your siblings. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta, and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Shanu Muksim. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.